Rusty Hutson from Diversified Gas and Oil is with me in the studio this afternoon. Rusty, welcome back. Nice to see you.
Glad to be here.
Trading statement out this morning, the acquisition of those Titan assets, now fully complete.
Fully integrated, finished the last closing September 30th, and we've already started seeing the operational efficiencies that come along with the scale that we obtained with that acquisition.
And so now you've got around 17,000 wells?
17,000 wells, producing around 18,000 barrels of oil equivalency per day, which makes us one of the top AIM producers as of production. And we're also starting to see increased margins from that acquisition as we've increased our margins by about 9 basis points from about 35% to 44%.
Well, with those gross margins improving and the reduction in operating costs here, just give us the bigger picture. How have you managed to achieve this?
Well, it's all about operational efficiencies with a much larger scale. So we've added a lot more assets within a very tight geographic area. And as we do that, we're able to wring out costs, become more efficient in the way we operate the wells, taking care of neglected wells, because typically the seller didn't take care of the wells as well as they should have. And by doing all those things, it just results in a more efficient operation.
And as part of the Titan acquisition, you brought over some of their people as well, have you?
We have. We added, here recently, we've added about 22 of their finance and accounting folks. We've also added a chief financial officer here since July.
Well, tell me a bit more about your CFO, Eric Williams.
Eric comes to us from a large publicly traded company in the U.S. With a very extensive financial background and also investor relations background.
You talk about what sets you apart from others, other operators, and it's that real scale. You reckon that gives you the leg up as to why others can't replicate what you're doing?
Yeah, I mean, it's all about a contrarian type model. We're going where other people don't want to go, and we're buying assets at very cheap multiples, and then we're operating them more efficiently. And that model just works for us. That's our model, and it's all about cash flow.
And you're predominantly a gas producer.
About 90% of our production is gas.
90% gas, but you're encouraged by the strengthening oil price?
We are. Anytime the commodity prices are increasing, whether it's gas or oil, it has a positive impact on our earnings.
I suppose you were talking about AIM companies and what set you apart a moment ago. Another factor, a significant factor, being you're paying a dividend.
We do. We're one of maybe two on AIM that pays a dividend consistently, which we declared one in September, which is payable in December.
You came to London on AIM back in February, I think it was. You and I spoke at the time.
February 3rd.
You must be pretty pleased with the progress you've made so far this year.
It probably has happened even faster than I imagined it would. But we've definitely checked all the boxes of everything we said we would do.
And the last time we spoke, I remember very clearly you're saying, don't be surprised if we make another acquisition which could potentially double our production. You got a couple of potential projects on the table that you're looking at the moment?
Yeah, every day we're consistently looking at other opportunities. What I would say is that we're staying very focused on what we're paying from a valuation standpoint to make it work. And we're staying right now in our geographical area of Appalachia, where we get the most operational efficiencies out of it.
Where you get the most operational efficiencies, and is it fair to say that's where you feel the most comfortable?
It's our backyard. It's where we operate every day. It's where all of our people are from and where our reputation's at.
And without going over too much old ground, looking ahead to 2018, what's the main focus for you? What would you like to achieve there?
We will continue to look at more acquisitions and executing on those when they make sense, staying within our valuations, being disciplined in the way we look at the acquisitions, and continuing to execute on them. We've got the capital now. We still have, both from a credit and from a equity standpoint, and we're going to execute them.
You've got the capital. You're clearly encouraged. What are shareholders telling you? Are they as excited about the opportunities as you are?
I think they are. I mean, our stock price is up about 25% since IPO as of today, and they see the ability to generate cash flows from these assets with the dividend that we're paying. And so the proof's in the pudding.
The proof's in the pudding. Rusty, always good to see you. Thanks very much.
Thank you for having me.